Hi, this is Carl the Landscape Guy. When I come home from work in the evening and the remote control for my garage is not in my work vehicle, it can be really annoying. Thankfully, Meross has sent me the MSG100 Smart Wi-Fi Garage Door Opener for this video. This way I can easily open the garage door with my phone. I will install and test this module today. The device comes in a small box with all the necessary cables. Here's the sensor cable, the USB power adapter, and the MSG100 module with all the necessary connections. There are also some double-sided 3M adhesive strips, which should help with the installation process. First, I'll set up the software for the device. To do this, I connect the module to the power supply. On the smartphone, the app Meross is downloaded and installed. After opening the app, I log in or create an account with an email and password. After that, enable the app to use your location. And now we can add our new device. To do this, I press the plus sign at the top right corner and then choose Garage Door Opener from the list. Here is where they walk you through the setup. There are a vast majority of manufacturers of garage door openers stored in the software. But even if yours is not there, you can still use this device by doing a simple compatibility check. Most garage door openers are controlled via contacts 1 and 2 with a push of a button. To test this, I open the case of my garage door opener and look for the contacts. With insulated pliers, I connect contacts 1 and 2, and the motor starts up. So I tap on yes, it works. Now it says to please connect the power cable to the module. Okay, I already have. Now when the LED light under the Wi-Fi symbol flashes yellow-green, the module is ready to connect. Okay, that's working, so let's continue. Now it takes a few seconds. By the way, this app, including the setup, is available in all languages. After the app has found the module, I can rename the device. I'm calling it Garage 1. Now the module has to be connected to the existing Wi-Fi. So I select my home Wi-Fi network and enter the associated password. This will only take a few seconds and then the software is completely installed. Now you see here the Garage 1 button is set up. Now I will connect the MSG100 Wi-Fi module and start connecting it to the motor. For safety reasons, I disconnect the motor power supply. Next, I loosen the screws of contacts 1 and 2 to connect the module to the existing garage door button. I put the wires from the module in parallel to the existing contacts and retighten the screws. Okay, that works, and I lay the wireless module on top of the motor for now. Next, I want to install the sensor. With this magnetic sensor, I can later check on the Meross app whether the garage door is open or closed. When the door is closed, the sensor and magnet must line up parallel to each other. But the top surfaces don't need to face each other, which gives you several more options on where you can mount them. I use two of the supplied pre-cut adhesive strips and attach them to the back of the sensor. I found a good place for the sensor here on the center rail. I stick the sensor with the cable to the metal rail, which does not move. The sensor magnet is put on right next to it and will move away from the sensor when the door is opened. Make sure you press firmly and you're done. The sensor cable is now secured on top of the center rail to the garage door opener with tape so that it doesn't fall down. The sensor cable can be simply plugged into the MSG100 module. There are still adhesive strips left over that I can use to attach the module onto the rail. The length of the cable is designed for larger garage doors as well. I roll up the rest of the cable so that it doesn't hang down. Now I'll take care of the power supply. I use a power strip to supply the motor and Wi-Fi module with power. There are enough adhesive strips left over to attach it right next to the plug. Here I use zip ties to hold the cables together. So everything is finished and I can put the cover back on the motor. I'm curious if the whole setup works properly. I open the Meross app and press the button to open the garage. And it works fine and also reacts promptly. You get a status message that the garage door has been opened. This can be changed in the settings as desired. I also like that you can be notified when the garage door is open after a certain time of day. Thank you so much to the company Meross for this product, which indeed does what it should. Another clear advantage of the product is that the existing remote controls and buttons for the garage continue to function as usual. At the same time, every family member can open the garage with his or her phone via the app. But the most important thing is that from now on, I can come home from work and go straight in the garage. I hope this video was helpful. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, this is Carl the Landscape Guy.